Hi friends, so we will continue the last stage of Ignatius remaining, and you have a request to do all remedies in this way. So we can form a series of small clippings which you all can club together and study a remedy thoroughly. Definitely we can work on it, and I will try my best to put it forth in future videos. So the last stage of Ignatia which was remaining, like how a movie ends, okay? Now movie is ending, climax is there. You never know Ignatia will go in what direction now, whether the ending will be a happy ending or a sad ending, okay? But Ignatia is the one who will not let things just go on wrongly. If there's something wrong happening in society, or if society, in the sense her society, she is not like Kaustikam who will worry for the entire society or the nation or whole world. No, Ignatia's main priority is what? Her main priority, her closed ones. Death of loved one affects her. Neglection or rejection from a loved one affects her. Whatever is happening between her and the loved one, between her and the family, that is affecting her the most. Okay, so for her, that is her society, her entire world. If they have done something wrong to her, not something, even slightest of wrong to her, okay, slightest of contradiction, slightest of neglect, slightest of reprimand, reproach, that is the mental agility of Ignatia. She is a overly sensitive female, and she is very quick to perceive and quick to act. Okay, so for a long time, maybe this can be a picture that for a long time she just bears and bears and bears, bears mildness, bears suffering without outrage, cowardice, no courage to express her opinion. Okay, maybe she stays like that, but a point will come where she will break down. You know, Ignatia, हमारे HHF में बोलते हैं, Ignatia राख है, राख राख है ना, उसके अंदर आग होती है, ऊपर से देखने में ठंडी होती है, लेकिन उसको छुएंगे तो आग दिखेगी. ओके, सो दिस इज़ व्हाट इट इज़ लाइक ऐश. आई एम सेइंग इट इन इंग्लिश, व्हाई, यू नो, बिकॉज आई वांट पीपल हु डोंट अंडरस्टैंड हिंदी एंड मराठी, I want HHF to reach to that level where it is understood, and it is the message of HHF goes to every corner of our country and the globe. And I think English being a universal language, and I think it will be easy for HHF to reach to those corners. And this is my main aim, to talk in English. So Ignatia is that ash. It is that ash which looks cool from outside, but if you touch, you will see the fire within, okay? That fire within, that jealousy, that envy, that anger within. So better not to touch her, better to give her dues, okay? To every woman, you give her her dues, whatever she has done to the society, whatever she does for the family, she needs to be respected. She needs only little love, only little attention, not much. She doesn't want everything, you know. Ignatia doesn't want you to take her name whole day or give her gifts entire day. No, she just wants little. You give me little, I am attached to you, I am doing so much for you. That is her basic requirement. And even if little she misses out on, then she just goes into disconcerted, okay? Disconcerted is such a big thing for Ignatia. It can be reflected in a very small way also. If the opposite person is sensitive enough to understand the initial stage of disconcerted. And if not, if the sensitivity of people around her is not very good, that disconcerted can become a very intense thing also. It can be a very drastic step for her to take, where she just refuses to eat. Eating refuses to eat is what? Na? Eat is what? See, we have instincts, okay? So, food, shelter, clothing, survival and sex are the five instincts on which a human being thrives. So for food, so eating is the instinct. So basic instinct, na, basic requirement of for a human being to survive. So when instinctually the person doesn't want to survive, so or the person says that I don't want to live, it's better to die. So first thing what a human being will leave is eating food. Okay, so eating, refuses to eat, is the basic nourishment that the person doesn't want for himself, and that is how is reflected in Ignatia in a very intense manner, where she will not want to be talked to, she will not want to be discussed what went wrong with her or anything wrong that she has done. She will show her disapproval. Okay, now when things are going wrong in the house to a very big extent, she is still bearing, keeping within the morals of society, within the morals of the house, she is acting in the best way possible. She is giving her best and behaving that she's what a best daughter-in-law can do, a daughter can do for the house. But if the people in the house are still doing those wrongs, remember the movies, if you have not seen, you should see to understand what Ignatia is and what her limits can be. She can go to a large extent to take her stand and take the stand of a woman whom wrongs have been are being done. Okay, Fool Bane Angare, that's the movie of Rekha. Then there is Damini. Okay, then there are many such movies in Bollywood, if you see, where fool is flower is become Angare, you know, outrageous she goes, and she will it is a remedy for women's liberation movement, how doctor, one of the doctors has put up in Materia Medica. So if you see the Materia Medica, it says, so for women's liberation movement means she is the lady who will work, who will act for the liberation of those women to whom wrongs are done, who have to suffer and who are made to suffer for wrong practices of others, because of others, why they should suffer. And till a point will come where she will suffer, and then she will blast, she will break out of her limitations, she will care for the morality, and that morals will come out in a form of violence, that this is correct and I cannot bear wrong happening anywhere in any form. Okay, then anger violent will come out, violence, rage leading to deeds of violence, destructiveness of clothes are the closed people, the people who are most close to her, and if they have done wrong to her and any female in her house, she will just break the limits of bearing, and she will, destructiveness of clothes, she will not bother who they are, and she will just expose them to the society. She will expose them in the court, she will expose them in front of people, that no matter what you belong, what, how you are related to me, you have to be punished and you have to go through hell of time. Now enough is enough. Okay, this is how her destructiveness, rage from contradiction, she goes outrageous, censorious, quarrelsome with her family, complaining. She will go to the right authority and make the matter come in eyes of those people and make the offense punishable. Okay, these are those ladies, those Ignatias come to that extent, who work for women's liberation movement. So these ladies are the ones on whom the other ladies look up to, that she will do it, she has got that power. Okay, so this is Ignatia. And in Materia Medica, so the last stage of my study of remedy, it ends with studying Materia Medica. Okay, so after forming the journey through rubrics, I go and study Materia Medica of various authors, that what have they told. Like in Kent's Materia Medica, that's the most basic Materia Medica that I first came across when I entered BHMS, and entire 5.5 years I have been only reading Kent Materia Medica for all remedies, the first one to rely on. Okay, so the Materia Medica say very nice rubrics and symptoms, but a most repeated one are that it is a remedy of contradictions. Okay, so in a situation where something is expected but Ignatia behaves in an opposite way, like if there is pain, inflamed part, the inflamed part is looking red, inflamed, and it seems as if, you know, it will be very hot to touch, and the opposite person feels, oh, no, we should not touch it, it must be very painful for the person, so it is looking swollen, but Ignatia wants that touch. Ignatia wants a hard pressure over her painful part, and that pressure, that touch is not painful to her, it in fact relieves the pain. So Ignatia wants that if I am affected, you have to touch me, you have to give me that pressure, you have to understand me, don't just keep looking at me, just looking at me in that pain is aggravating my pain, so better come and give me that pressure that, you know, things are fine, you have to understand me, you have to come closer to me and not just be at a distance. So then there is one symptom where there is globus hystericus, it is told, okay, where she feels a lump in the throat, something arising from the esophagus, from the stomach, and that bolus comes in the throat and it feels as if it will come out, but it doesn't come out and she has to take it inside. Okay, then there is pain in throat, the throat looks inflamed, red, and doctor will feel, oh, she cannot swallow anything, but for her swallowing a solid food or swallowing gives her relief, a hard pressure again, and liquid gives her trouble. So don't just so how we saw swallowing of liquid in the remedy before, in aconite, it relieves liquid swallowing, okay, cold liquid, cold drink, okay. Now for Ignatia, that solid swallowing gives her relief. So again it comes in this way, where Ignatia wants that she needs to talk something, okay, that idea, that thought, that fear, that anxiety, or that anything what has affected her, anger it could be, that she wants to express something, and that expression just comes and goes. Because of her morals, she keeps quiet, and then she takes it inside that it is better to keep quiet rather than speak up. Okay, so then it is again and again mentioned in hysterical tendencies, in hysterical women. So hysterical woman in Ignatia is not that who will just go out and shouting and screaming and pulling hair and beating others or abusing others. It is not that kind of hysteria in Ignatia. Whatever disconcerted state it is, Ignatia will always be within her morals. She will not leave her morals in any stage, okay, in any state. She will be the one. How to identify Ignatia is that when I take the child into consideration and I feel this must be Ignatia's anger, so I come to know that she doesn't harm her sibling in any way. She will hit the sibling when others are not looking around. With whom she has jealousy, she will take that revenge, but her revenge is very mild. It is not going to hurt her sibling. She will take care of that thing, that my behavior should not harm anybody else. That care is there, that morals is there. Within her morals, she will express her anger. Okay, so her hysterical is not like other remedies of Hyo, Stram, aisa kaisa, un log ka jaisa violence nahi hai usme, there is no violence up front, okay. Her hysteria is, hysterical means what, you know, any kind of emotional shock or mental shock that brings about physical symptoms is hysterical, okay, that is hysteria. So that is any emotional thing can affect her as a shock to her and she can suffer. So there was a case where she had a chocolate cyst, okay, chocolate cyst of ovaries, that is endometrial endometriosis cyst. Okay, it is very painful condition, and she had it for 4 years. She had been suffering that pain and that intermittent bleeding and intense pain. I can't describe how much pain she used to go through every cycle. She couldn't just get up from bed at all. She would not do any work in the house. And she had been married since 4 years, and she had been just suffering. So I went back, I asked, what went wrong? Can you share with me? So then her mother told that actually she lost her father, and she was the younger one in the family. She had one elder sister who ran away and got married years back. So since then, she was the one who took up that role of taking care of her parents and not doing anything wrong. And she was the one to whom parents had all expectations from. And for her father, she was a gem of his eyes. And immediately after her marriage, he got a heart attack, and she took him he had a heart attack, he somehow survived, and then after that there was chronic issue which was going on, and he used to suffer, and she would take him from hospital to hospital, and he would still not recover, and in 1.5 months time he just passed away. And that shock set in her mind, it had such a huge impact on her mind that she couldn't come out of it. And she would feel that it is because of me that he passed away. I could not give him any solution. I couldn't take him to a good hospital. I couldn't take him for a good treatment. And if I would have been better, then maybe he would have survived. My actions, that guilt she took, and she just dwell her mind over it. So she just keeps thinking that and that same thing repeatedly. So that one thing, ailments from losing, grief from losing objects, okay, object or any loved one who's very close to her, emotional closeness is too much in Ignatia. So when she feels that this is something I love, and her attachment is so strong, and if she loses that, she just stays there only then. Pain in spots. In Ignatia, there is in physicals pain in spots. So this is that spot, you know, where she gets stuck and she can't come out of it. From there, that disconcerted happens, and that disconcerted is no time limit. It could be for a few minutes, 2 hours, to years also. So this was one case I had to say. Then there was one more case which I thought I would share, and I'm not able to recollect. Maybe I'll share. I'm going to do this compare and contrast of Ignatia with other remedies. So that time I will share another very good case of Ignatia. So keep watching, keep liking, keep commenting, keep subscribing, and we will do next remedy, that will be Natramur. Okay, so watch for more. Thank you.